with Squeaks, but don't worry, we'll have time for both. Oh hey, Squeaks and I are planning a trip to the Robot Hall of Fame in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Oh, okay. I guess we'll see C-3PO first, and I can visit Tom Servo later. Ooh, and we'll get to take an airplane ride to get there. I love going on planes. Plane rides are so cool. Oh, it's okay to be nervous. Squeaks has never been on a plane before, but that's okay. I'll be with you the whole time. Hey, do you think if I told you what to expect, that would make it less scary? First, we're going to go to the airport. It can be a little busy in the airport. It's full of lots of people, all in a hurry to get where they're going. We might have to wait in a line a few times, and it can be hard to wait, but it's easier if you bring something to do, like a book or a game. Oh, you can totally bring your tablet, Squeaks. Next, we're going to find a place called a gate. It's not a gate like the one on a fence. It's an area of the airport. Everyone getting on our flight to Pittsburgh will meet up at the same gate together. We'll wait there and listen for an announcement that it's time to board the plane. And that's when we'll get on. Ooh, yes, there will definitely be bathrooms on the plane. So we'll sit down and then buckle up. The flight attendants will make some announcements that will help us stay safe on the trip. And then it's time for takeoff. You'll feel the plane going faster and faster as it drives down the runway. It can get up to nearly 300 kilometers per hour. That's almost as fast as a race car. And then the plane lifts off into the air. The takeoff will sound pretty loud, and it can feel a little bumpy. That's totally normal. And once the plane is above the clouds, everything should feel pretty smooth. Oh, well, you're right. It won't feel quite like being on the ground. Let's see, what can we expect? It's going to be loud. Takeoff is about as loud as a jackhammer. And even after takeoff, the inside of the plane will be about as loud as a blender or a car wash. Our ears will get used to it, but it will definitely sound different. And as we get higher and higher up, the air pressure gets lower. The air around you isn't just empty space. It has weight, and it pushes down. We call that push air pressure. The plane will get so high up that there will be less air pressure to push on us. And the place we notice that most is our ears. And as the plane gets higher, your ears might start to feel funny. You'll feel some pressure, and if you move your jaw around, it kind of feels like it goes pop. So our ears might need a little help to adjust to the change in air pressure. You can chew gum or suck on candy if your grown-up says it's okay. And you can yawn, or you could swallow, and a drink of water might help with that. Oh, that's true. Your plane might also go through something called turbulence, which makes the ride a bit bumpy. Even though it feels like the plane is going over a bump like in the car, it's actually just air. It just means the air around the plane is shifting and moving around, like the wind you feel when you're on the ground. It's okay. Turbulence is a normal part of flying. The pilot might even tell us when we're going to feel some bumps. Finally, when we're getting close to Pittsburgh, the plane will start getting ready to land. As we get lower, you might feel your ears pop again as the air pressure changes again. You might feel your tummy drop a bit as the plane gets lower. And then you'll feel the wheels hit the ground and the plane is driving down the runway again, which means it's almost time to start our amazing vacation. Oh, you're right, Squeaks. Let's get packing. We'll be off to the museum in no time. Thanks for joining us. If you want to keep learning and having fun with me, Squeaks, and all of our friends, be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time here at the Fort.